In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to create reports and customize reports in Microsoft Access 2016. This process is going to start with the very basics, and then we're going to move into some of the more advanced features of customizing reports in Microsoft Access. So in this case, we have a database with three tables. And if you wanted to learn more as to how to work with an Access database, please refer to the previous videos on this tutorial. So we have three tables. We have a contracts table. Let's assume we have contracts for customers, then we have a customers table, and then we have an invoices table. So the tables look like this. Now, in our case, we also have those tables linked together, which is a common feature of an Access database or any of the relational databases out there. So as such, if we go here under Database Tools, and then we go under Relationships, you'll see that we have those tables linked together. And if you want to learn more about these, you can check the previous tutorials as well. And now we can create reports based on each one of those tables individually, or we can create reports by pulling data from multiple tables. For example, if we wanted customer ID from the customers table and the first name and last name from the customers table, then we can also pull, for example, the contract number. We can pull also the amount and the signing date and the contract type, because those two tables are linked together. So let's learn how to do this. To create a report, we need to go here under Create tab, and then we can click here under Reports, and notice we have this whole section with reports. So we can create using the design option, the blank report, start from scratch, or we can use the report wizard. If you're just starting with the databases, I would suggest that you start with a report wizard, as that is going to be the simplest way for you to learn how to do this. So we go here under report wizard, and then you'd basically pick the first table that you want to pick the fields from. So in our case, we go to the customers table, and let's say we want the first name, and we want the last name, and let's say we want the street address, the city, zip, state, and email. So these are just some of the fields from that table. Now in our first instance here, we are going to simply create a report just from one table so that we get the idea. And then we are going to pull the data from multiple tables. So we go here under Next, and then we choose how do we want to group those, if we wanted to create groupings of those customers. In our case, for now, we're just going to leave this alone. And then we click on Next. And then here it's asking us, do we want to sort those customers? So we could technically choose to sort those by first name or by last name or by zip or any of those fields here. So we are going to just say we want to sort them by first name. Then you can also choose additional sorting criteria as well, subsequent ones. Typically, the first option here is going to take priority, then it's going to go to the second priority, and so on. So we click on Next, and then it's going to create the report here in the tabular format, and then you can also choose whether you want the orientation to be portrait or landscape. If it's a lot of fields that you're going to have in your table, it's best probably to choose landscape. But for now, with the number of fields that we have, we just can create it using the portrait view. And then we give it a name here. So just a customer list. We can call this whatever we want, customer list. And then it's going to give us a preview of this report. We click on Finish here, and notice the preview has been created. So if I close it here on the right hand side, now notice under Reports, I have a new customer list report. If I double click on it, notice I can see all those customers here. Now you'd say, well, it's kind of cutting here the email field on the right hand side. How can I change that? How can I customize that? We can customize any of those reports that we create a couple ways, or you can do this in a couple ways. You can either go here under View. As soon as we have selected the report here, we can click on View, and you can change it to the layout view here. So that's one way to customize it. And this is under the layout view. We can go and simply resize the fields. So that's one way to do it. So notice I'm just readjusting the width of those fields. Now probably the address needs to be longer. Notice I'm going to the right here and such. The state doesn't have to be as wide. Then the zip, I can adjust this accordingly. Notice you need to adjust the labels here on the top as well. I'm pressing here Control A to select everything. And we can also go here under Format, and we can change, for example, the font for this to be a smaller size. So you can control how this will display by utilizing or changing the font visual aspects of it. That's one way for you to customize this. If you wanted, by the way, these fields here on the top, the labels, to be in a different format, notice I'm holding down the Control key here and I'm selecting all those labels. Now under the Format, then I can go here under Format and then make this bold. I can choose a different font size and all that type of stuff. Notice also under the Format, we had this Select All option that I did earlier using the Control A key on the keyboard. If you wanted to change the top or the heading of this, you can simply go here and double click on the heading and then customize this any way that you want. So that's one easy way to customize this report that we just created here. Notice that there are different designs here that you can apply as well to this report. So notice you have these new tabs here on the very top under, and these are typically referred to as the contextual tools, since we are tinkering and working here with the report module of the database and adjusting the layout and the design of it. Notice we have this like design tab, arrange tab, format tab, and even page setup. So you can change the look and the feel of this specific report. Notice also under the design tab, you also have these design themes. So if I wanted to apply a different look and feel to this, I can apply one of those themes. Now to go back to the normal view for this report, we go here under View and then Report View, and notice it has changed, it has been modified with the changes that we applied earlier. Another way to customize your report is also to utilize the design view, and I'll go more in depth about this shortly here. So you go here under Design View after we have selected our report. And this is kind of more complex. And again, notice you have here, again, the same contextual tools on the very top. However, you can change here. Notice it says Page Header. If I wanted to move this field a little bit farther to the left and adjust the width and such, again, these are the labels. Notice I can do them more precisely from here. So you can adjust the width of those fields here, and you get the idea at this point. Now these would be just the labels on the top, and these would be the actual fields in the bottom. Notice you can also adjust the footer, what will show up as at the bottom of the report from here as well. So let's assume that I didn't need the email field. You can simply press delete from here and delete both the label and the actual field, the bottom stuff here. It's actually the field from the table that it's linking to the table. And then we can close this report here on the top, save the changes, and now double click on the report again. And notice we do not have that field for the email. Also, if you wanted to see a preview of this, you can click here on the top left and choose Print Preview. And this is how our report will look at this point. Notice you also have the footer here, the page footer. We can close the preview from here. And at this point, let's also learn how to add a field to an existing report. So let's assume that this is our report, and then somehow we missed adding the email field to an existing report. Of course, we could create something from scratch. However, in certain cases, your report might be fairly complicated and you want to add another field or a couple fields. So here's how you add the other fields to it. You can right click on the report and choose Design View, or you can go up here under View, under the Home tab, and choose Design View. So you'll kind of want to do this from the Design View. Now, on the right-hand side or on the very top here, notice how it says Add Existing Fields. So you can click here on Add Existing Fields. So notice we have the list of fields here from our table. And we can move this a little bit. And then we want to add here the email field. So we simply drag it, but we need to drag it. Notice in this white spots here where the detail for the form is. We don't need to put it under page header. We want to put it under the detail area. This would be the content of our report. We are kind of linking this field with the actual table from the customer's table here. So this is not the label, it's actually the data from the table. So we simply drag it and we just drop it where we want it. Then adjust the positioning of it on that report, how you want it, how wide you want it, and all that type of stuff. And then notice at this stage, it's not giving us the option to put this the label for it. Because if I run this right now, and I save the design, notice it's not going to have the label here on the top as to what this is. We need to basically go under the Design View again. And in this case, the label is right there. But notice it's kind of like if we move this a little bit, notice the email label, it's over here to the left. What you can do is you can simply click on that email label, the one that it came in, or the one that it brought in, delete it, reposition your data field here, how you want it and how wide you want. And then above it, under the header area, that's where you need to create a new label for this. So to add the label on the header, what you do is you go here under the label area, here on the design. Notice there's this icon label here. And then choose where you want that label and how wide you want it. And then type in their email. Hit enter, and then reposition it the way you want it. Realign it. Same thing with the one here as well. And let's go under View here and choose Report View. Notice we have this email field created. If we wanted to change the formatting and adjust the formatting again, you can simply go under View, go under Layout View, and then under Design, apply a different theme or apply the theme that you had from before. Now notice in certain spots here, we have this, or for this, we might still need to adjust the formatting. Notice this has a border around it, this field. So we might need to adjust the formatting for it and get rid of the border. To change the border, there are a couple ways to do that. You can either right click here under the field, and notice I'm under the Layout View. You can do this also from the Design View. And if I go here under Properties for this object, so once I go to the property sheet for this specific field, notice here under Border, it says to use a border style solid, and I can change that so that it's just transparent or nothing. And then you can choose the border effect as well if you need it to. If I go here under and close this, now that border should not appear anymore. notice it's gone. If I wanted to change the size of the font, of course, go back to layout view. And for this field, you can go under the format tab and then change the size to match the rest of the form. And then if we go here under design tab again, then if we go and view this report, this is how it will look at this point. Instead of spending all this time to customize the look and feel of this, you can also go back here and use what's called the format painter. So you can copy the formatting of a specific cell and adjust it for other cells. So if I go back here to my layout view, and I'll go and undo some of those things that I had done earlier, so some of those changes. Notice right now, if I go back to view here, notice I have my border stuff again here. Go under Format Painter here from the layout view, and I can copy the formatting of an existing cell and apply it to another one. So I can go to any of these cells, go under Format here, and then use this icon right here, the Format Painter. That copies the formatting of an object and applies it to another object. So click on it, and then go to the other object, any of these here, and apply it. And now it's all changed automatically. So that's the easier way to do this. Then close it, click on Save Changes, and now you can double click on it, and this is your report. And this is the print preview of this report. So this is how you create a report. This is how you customize the report and how you remove fields from the report, and also how you add additional fields to the report if you had an existing one.